Well, we're already back from the Nationals for a couple of days, and things in our life have changed. Some of the things that used to be for givens are not given anymore. Let me take a minute and explain. Now, I didn't really plan it this way, but it's dovetailing into my life a little bit better than I thought it would. Rob has gotten his permit for the motorcycle, and we're riding every day, an hour or so in the morning before he goes to work and an hour or so at night, but it changes my whole schedule. And the way it's changed, it's kind of a strange thing. Normally this time of year I would be flying with the wild hogs every morning, but it's the only time Rob gets to be away from his job. He has regular hours he has to keep, and I have to be with him for about 45 days till he goes for his license. He can't ride by himself in the state of Jersey. And so I've kind of changed my whole schedule around, and I'm going to use these 45 days to do some things that I normally don't get to do. And one of them is today we're going to head down to South Jersey to Wall Stadium and check out the car racing. Billy knows one of the drivers personally. It's a good friend of his. And so we'll hopefully get to see some car action. Now, Karen's never been to one of these car races, and I haven't been to one. In fact, I've never been to one, not this type of racing. So we're going to use it as a little day to get a little excursion going. Rob's back from his ride. We're all petered out, and it's a good time to just relax for a little while. And it's something new, something you may find interesting. And I'm always up for something totally new that I haven't tried or done before. Now, of course, my days of racing are well behind me, thank God. And what is ahead of me, though, is we're going to be starting the big job. We're gathering all our parts together. We have the take-apart stuff. We got some decent wood I think will be usable, and we also got the plans from Charlie Reeves. But we're not going to be starting it until the end of the flying season. And one of the kind of neat things that happened for Karen and I over the course of this summer, again, we didn't plan it much this way, is Billy found two flying fields up by him that we can fly at any time, day or night. So we're going to be doing some flying up there with Billy. But that's not, and he's just about, well, he's well on the way to finishing his Strega ARF. I think we're going to do the final parts of it down in my shop. But I'm very happy. Here's one of the things I really liked. See in that box, there's a flat screen TV. So while we have our lunch out here or our supper, as the case may be, we get to watch, well, Speed Vision, whatever. Whatever to think, Karen likes the cooking channel. But we have used this porch. This porch was such a big job. It consumed about 10 months of our life. But boy, do we get to use it every night. And we've had company out here. We've had breakfast parties out here. It's just been absolutely wonderful the way this whole thing has worked out. We got a radio, a stereo, a TV. And of course, Karen constantly using her magic with the plants. And one of the best things of the whole summer is Andy. Now, who could have predicted Andy taking over our life like this? Not only our life, he's taking over the neighborhood. Andy, oh my God, is he cute. Andy, you want to be on Windy Videos? Oh, look at his tail is wagging. Yeah, I love Windy Videos. Oh, they're so boring. Oh, what a guy. Andy,
go for a walk.
Every day, he's the star of the neighborhood.
Out of before.
Yeah, it looks like it's clouding up. But we're going to go to the car races tonight.
Where's that?
In Wall Stadium.
Oh, okay.
Billy's got a friend that's racing one of the cars, and I don't know if we're going to get to see him win a race or crash or something. Who knows? Crash and burn. Andy, you want to go to the car races? No, I just want to hang out here. You want to be in the movies? You are in the movies. Hey, your landscaping looks great. While you were in Puerto Rico, I was taking pictures every day, if you want to see them.
Oh, good. I can blackmail my son.
Yeah. Looks like your son did a nice job. All right, Andy, we're going to the car races. And I hope it doesn't rain tonight. And it really has been an unpredictable, well, the whole year is unpredictable. Looks like it's clouding up now. It was real nice all day while we were out riding motorcycles. But we got to see, I didn't take any pictures. We're going to go up there one day this week, up to Billy's new flying field, which really looks like a nice place to fly. And we added to our little collection of things that we have in this area here of the garden to honor Chickie, including this year's Chickie plane, which we still need to get more flights on it. There's still a lot of trim left to do on that plane. Still in its infancy, and I hope we get to do it before the year's out. Now, having access to this new field during the time that we normally, it's a strange thing. We have to be done at the other field at 8:30, and with the wild hogs, and because of Rob riding, that's not really working out. But unpredictable. But there's one thing that is predictable. Every year, in all the years we've been in this house, 18 years, 17, I think, 17 or 18, Karen has always made us a wonderful house and home, a wonderful garden. And we just do enjoy every night sitting out here or sitting on our porch and sharing a few moments of this with our friends. And the last thing, you got to see this before we pack the car up to go to the races here. Look at these. This is Karen's garden that was 3 months ago was seeds. She's got corn as high as I am. Plants, zucchinis, cucumbers, lettuce. And of course, the wonderful baskets that she did this year. But I really do appreciate it, and I really do enjoy all the time we spend in our backyard. And now with the addition of the porch, and I hope very soon with the addition of Billy's new flying field. I think we got a lot of fun stuff coming up for the second half of this year. And as always happens, even like with the remake of the garage, everything is unpredictable. And if I could have only looked at this in the middle of last winter and seen how nice the garage would come out, see how well Rob is doing with his motorcycle riding time, and just see how much I'm enjoying this R1. It took me a long time to get all the decals off of it. I'm not a decal guy, but right now we got all the decals off. I like it a lot better in its plain Jane adult mode. I got the paint from Bobby Brookins. We're going to be painting that lower part of the fairing. Elaine Brookins has got the seat out being upholstered. Elaine's making me that special seat. And it's just been as good as it gets. Unpredictable, but good. And I sense that tonight we're going to have an adventure down in Wall Stadium, and we'll share it with you. It must be time to go to the races. Time to go. Time to go. Time to go to the races. Oh, nice red shirt. You match my Ferrari shirt. Time to wear the Ferrari hat, the John Cafaro Ferrari hat. One day a year we go to the races, we get to wear it.
Hi, we're matching.
Hey, we're matching, baby. Look at this, we got the big John Cafaro Ferrari shirts. Where's the Ferrari decal? You need the Ferrari decal, hey. Look at all this standing still traffic. Why are they going here? You would think it wouldn't be that popular. Look at this dude going by on a Ducati. Melinda, he's got Billy's bike. Get back here. My Ducati!
That's why we're done great. Going anywhere. And now she launched that at the top of the stand too.
Now what do they have? The monster trucks here too?
You just go straight in, so I don't...
Okay, we're in the pits, baby. We got pit passes and everything here.
Oh, there's Joey!
Look at this!
Payne.
Oh, this is Billy's friend, okay. Very cool.
Joey, I've never been to a race, so it should be great.
This is her first.
It's
beautiful.
She wants to know if you're going to let her drive the car around the pits.
Oh, yeah. I let my wife drive.
Nah. Not happening, huh?
She's now Racer X.
This is the car?
There's the car.
Show us your car.
Right here.
Oh, boy. Now we're going to go see his car.
Raising the big deals too tonight.
Oh, good, good. There's some real sticky tires. These tires are like motorcycle road race tires. You could reach in with your finger and pull a chunk out. They're so sticky. Well, they're not Greyhound buses. The smaller, the better. Look at the seat, Karen, where he's sitting. It's not exactly like in the in a car. Okay.
How are you?
Not too bad.
How are you?
No, you gotta sit most of the time.
Right.
And the tires are really soft. If they're like a motorcycle road race tire, I'm sure they last about the same amount of laps, too.
Right, we actually want to get one of the tires and bring them home. That's going to be our focus.
How long will that tire last?
Like a little... That's what we've been trying to do. Okay.
So this is our first time seeing the sprint cars run. This is going to be exciting. And we get right up where the action is. You would think I'd get some respect. You'd think I'd get some respect here. World champion race car driver, I get nothing. Nothing.
Don't put your fingers up my head. Don't do that with me.
No, I've got the camera over your head.
Oh, okay.
It's a Suzuki engine, right? Is that the best one, or does Yamaha work just as good? Or?
You can only use Suzuki or Kawasaki. They don't let the Yamaha open pistons in it.
Okay.
And they try and keep the cost down as much as they can.
Look at some of the cool paint jobs on these cars. She wants one. Hey, Billy. Billy, she wants one bad, I can tell. We don't really need a house to live in. We could live in our trailer.
Hey, here you go.
Some of these trailers you could live in.
As long as it has a blow dryer.
And his dad, Sam, everybody, is the operator of Sam's Racing Stuff, the collectible spot right here in Wall Street. Will be Mike Fulton.
You'll look hot in pink. There's no doubt about it.
Mike Fulton from Bridgewater, car number 90, starts for first place.
Don't you have one of those shirts that the girls cut the bottom of the shirt off to be sexy? Oh, there they have them up there. Get a Harley shirt. All right, you can go to Hooters after this is over. You could serve the hamburgers.
To the first five finishing positions, because the drivers in the first five spots will get starting positions. Roll through the pin area.
I can't believe I missed pizza at the racetrack.
Simmons, Keenan Simmons will be part of the starting lineup as well. There's Mike Fulton, the car number 90, your pole star.
No, 26 out of 30.
Lining up in front, spotting car number 15, the silver number 15.
Like to you that they're just driving around in a circle, but you got to remember, the fastest way around the course, the shortest distance, is on the inside. But you've got two factors. You want to carry momentum, and you want to carry speed. And what these guys are doing, they're trying to stay closest to the inside as possible. And what happens is the track develops the line.
That's Joey's at 36. But that's Joey, okay.
Joey Jet.
Hey, Joey's number 36. And they basically have 750 Suzuki motorcycle engines in these cars?
Yes.
Outstanding TQ tickets. get second place?
Yeah.
Second? Okay, cool.
Did you get money for second?
Yeah, yeah.
You got second, Kara.
Oh, yeah, you're on the
podium. I saw.
See you guys later.
We're going to head out and see how Joey did. He got second in his first heat race. I like how they cool the engines. You see the fans they have on there? That's very cool. It can't be real comfortable being in there. There's no air conditioning. Okay, there he is, number 36.
Your last Saturday night at car number 81. Welcome back, Tim Alley.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, before we get started with our feature events, and the first feature on tonight's program will be for the legend cars.
Show me what she looks like in, when she's in court. Lady Liberty. Oh, man.
We remember them now with a moment of silence and thank them for being part of our great family here at Wall.
Okay, we're rooting for 36 in this race. 36 black. He's about the fourth one back. Start. Nah, one guy spun out. Here's our guy. Got to restart the race. He's in second place now. Second place. The Spitfire is ahead of him. Joe Adamusco's Spitfire. Wallbridge, look at this. The Spitfire is winning the race. Getting ready for the restart. The Spitfire. He's ahead of Joey right now. Ready for the restart. Yellow flag.
second restart. Spitfire is still ahead. Rich Wallbridge in the Spitfire. Joey's number two on this restart. Getting ready for the third restart of this race. Okay, they're gonna, somebody got hurt on that.
Okay, the red flag coming out, ladies and gentlemen, for Don Adams, we understand. Don climbed from the car. He made pretty heavy contact with the fence, but Don got out of the car. He's walking down the track being assisted by the rescue crew, but he is going to be checked over by the ambulance. There's Don. Yes, it is. Nice round of applause for his partner driver. One of the very best in TQ Major competition. Boy's a favorite here at Wall. And again, he climbed from that car under his own power, but then started feeling some discomfort there, and after making some really hard contact with the fence over there on turn two.
All right, Joey's back in second position. Second place. Somebody's out. Whoa. I thought the guy in first place got nudged. This is the Dave Midgley car right here. Midgley's purple and blue 09. Midgley's still doing well. Okay, our pony in this race is number 32. Here he is. Joey's number 32. There he is. He's not starting near the front, so I don't know how this is going to work out. He's about 3/4 of the way to the back. That was Joey who spun out. Number 32? Oh, that's not good. That's our guy. That's our friend Joey. Joey's in this car right here.
Quite a bit of damage to the front of that car, just rolled down to the infield.
It looks like they got to cut the 32 car apart to get the guy out, to get Joey out. Yeah, it looks like they're taking a body off, maybe. I don't know. That doesn't sound good.
Anyway, what brings you back here? You're awesome. Very good. Yes, he is. Jamie Spano. All right, well, thank you. You're going to come back often? All right, we'll make sure Joey's racing. What's he going to do?
Looks like they're going to flatbed Joey's car off of the track.
Thank you very much, Jeff. Congratulations to our winners today. The Bison and the Qantas 50-50. Yeah, good to see you today.
Yeah, I think they got it on a flatbed now. Maybe it's bent in such a way they can't really get it on.
I never saw that.
Yeah. All right, now they got to restart the race. up at the other end too. Drilled here. There's a nice trailer. Buddy 32. You'll be famous, and not in a good way, but...
Well, the number two was good. That was a good run.
Yeah, it was a good run.
Yeah.
That would be in a lot of heavyweight people all over the world.
Well, as we leave Wall Stadium, there's still one race left to go, but we want to beat the traffic. There's awful traffic getting home. The traffic from here can be a two-hour... 5 miles an hour. Yeah, this one's all, this one's shot. Oh my God. This could be expensive.
Oh yeah, that one's torture.
Well, let's hope our car is still in the parking lot when we go back there. Nobody used the tires off my car for a pit stop or something.
Oh yeah.
Come on, it was fun. You got to admit.
It definitely was fun.
Was it fun?
This Billy is... Billy is an okay guy. I don't care what John Cafaro says about him. Well, nobody stole a car. Now the only thing left to do is see if we can get home within before midnight. Well, it looks like we left early enough before the real traffic is hitting. Home again, jiggity jig.
The driver can't have head.
It's right by guy's tail.
Now, it really was a lot of fun last night, hanging out with Billy and his friend who was driving a sprint car and had that accident. That's a pretty serious accident, but he didn't get hurt. Now, what I'm trying to do, one of my motives here, I got this, the Rojet 61, the light case one, and I wanted to set it up in a Spitfire with a muffler. And what I wanted to do is ultimately leave this plane up at Billy's. We're going to be going up there to his new field behind the church, which looks like a pretty nice place to fly. And I want to leave a plane up there so I can ride up on my motorcycle from time to time. And, we can just take the plane. We basically go across the street. You could actually walk there from his house in a pinch. But I wanted to set this up, and I wanted to get Billy to fly this for a little while, too. He's gotten to the point where I think he also has Jose's plane, and he has his own Strega almost finished. So I thought this would be another one just to get him some flying experience. And we, the reality is we got to make some room here in the cellar for our new project, the big job. But I think this will be a lot of fun. But the other thing we're going to do today, and it's a kind of a rainy day, kind of a cloudy, rainy day, we're going to head down once a year. We go down to South Jersey to see our friends Steph and Jim and their absolutely great dog. We love the dog. We call her Ice Cookies. And assuming it's not going to rain the total day, we'll get to see some of the Victoriana houses, walk the shore, get about a 3-mile walk in, and have a great cookout at their house, assuming the weather holds up. But I want to get this done before we go, because I don't know what night this week or what afternoon we're going to go up to Billy's, and I want to check this new field out. Well, they were calling for rain all day today, but it looks like it's going to be a reasonably nice day. We're headed down to the Jersey Shore to one of the really nice Victorian communities where our friends Steph and Jim live. We do this probably at least once a year, and we always enjoy their hospitality. It's a great place to visit. The Jersey Shore is really, if you've never been to the Jersey Shore, it is a very special place. Can be a little trafficy getting there, but it looks like we ducked a bullet today. Turned out to be a super nice day. I can't believe it. And they said it was going to rain all day. And not far from here is where when Joe Cassie and I had the machine shop, our machine shop was right under that water tower over there. Of course, that's all in the past now. Raritan Bay. People fishing over there. Now look, they got some of the flower pots similar to what his. No, they're different, but some nice stuff. Yeah. They sure have their share of porches and flowers here. This is the old Victorian section here. Some of the ones they're working on, yeah. Oh, look at this one.
That's nice.
Yep, for anybody who has never been down to Jersey Shore, it's a pretty special place.
There's some big ones there.
Yeah. I remember this one. We walked here before.
Yeah, we walked. Well, they may want to walk after lunch too. I'd be up for that. Yeah, we walked all the way down to that big pavilion down at the end.
Yep.
Look at that bike, isn't that cute?
Yeah. Yeah, you got a lot of nice stuff here. But it's the buildings that are just really cool. Here's a plane towing a banner up there. Pretty cool buildings.
To the left.
Yep, if you like old architecture, boy, it's hard to beat this. If you like porches, now there's a porch.
This is Main
I'm just amazed that it turned out to be such a nice day when they predicted rain all day, thunderstorms. Oh, look at the porches on this one. Oh, Lord, yeah. Something big. Yeah, if they're gonna walk, if we're gonna walk after lunch, that'd be, this would be a nice area to walk down.
This is a little town here. Maybe we can stop and walk.
Quaker Inn. Look at a horse-drawn carriage down there. Yep, I remember that. So where do you want to walk? Which side of the street?
Across the street in the shade.
In the shade? Well, look at a woodwork on this one here. Talk about woodwork. Holy mackerel. This is what we love about this area. Almost everything's really restored nicely. I bet Walbridge is impressed with this, the architecture here. Find something we can't live without? Nice little shopping area. Okay. And the main thing of all. Oh, after a nice short little shopping spree, we're headed out to Stephan Jim's. Here on a beautiful Jersey shore.
And left.
Okay, Zelda, you got it. Zelda, the GPS girl. Look at this one down here, Kara.
Drive 200 feet, then turn left, then turn left.
You think we should turn left? Maybe we should turn left. I've been thinking about turning left myself. We actually have Andy living next door to us, who is, you've met Andy when you were by our house. Oh, and this is Big Andy, Giant Andy. Hey!
You know, Paul and Lynn was supposed to
go. Hey!
She had something going today, so she couldn't make.
I don't know about you. Andy says he wants to see video of you. Big video. We need video of ice cookies here.
Jim has outdone himself again.
Look how pretty.
And just in the middle of a wonderful meal, the sky's clouding up and it's looking like it may rain. No motorcycle ride today, I guess. Is it raining yet? We moved the table. It's sunny over there. Grab the table. Oh, man. What'd she do, eat a pound of cheese? Boy, and this was an absolutely fabulous day until the thunder came. Thunder Dooley here.
I said, I was full of smoke.
I said, we're choking.
I said, where the original...
Hey, I'm getting wet out here. It's pouring. I'm getting wet. What the hell's going on here? I want to go back to Rutherford and be in Wendy's garden.
Captain Nemo of the good ship Lollipop here.
Please take me back. Put me under the canopy. Please. I want to go back and live with Wendy.
And it's turned into a rare Brazilian sun shower of sorts. And of course, the sun is shining brilliantly. Now, our plan was to go for a big walk down on the shore. Here, we're only a couple blocks from the shore, but I don't know if they're going to postpone it or not. Come on, it's time to earn your keep. Time to earn your keep. They got the hoop out. Come on. Come on. Time to do your trick.
Come on, buddy.
Hey!
Come on, here's a big one. Chris, come on. Here we go. Big one. Big one. Up we go. Come on, hurry up. Hurry up. Come on.
Karen doesn't have this much trouble making me jump through the hoop. All right.
Come on, no, dance.
Hey.
She's full of cheese. Are you full of
that cheese?
Cheese
is holding her down.
Let me see that belly.
The
belly all the way.
Oh.
Come on, all the way. Let me see the belly. Come on, Chris. Give me your whole belly. Come on, hurry up. The whole belly. Whole belly.
She's probably thinking, what do you think? What do you think I am? A trained, an animal dog?
You gotta
she
give is trained. Say please. Please.
No, I'm fine. I'm just
watching. Say please. Come on. Say please. No. Say please. Oh, that's a belly. You did it.
I do that sometime when Karen's giving me orders. I roll over and show her the belly.
I'll see the belly.
Oh!
That's please.
Hey!
Sweet delicious. She's delicious. She is delicious.
Tell me something. Do you love Wendy? Wink your eye if you love Wendy.
Can I see your belly, Chris? Where's your belly?
Wink your eye if you love Wendy.
This is all no
trick. Oh, please. That Wendy is so mean.
Resting, Dad.
That Wendy is so mean. I wish he'd go home, go back to Rutherford. Who cares if it's raining outside? He's torturing me. Aww. What a cutie. Well, it's almost time to go. You're lucky. Time for us to go back to the real world. Party's over. Well, this night ended on really a pleasant note. Except now we got to make that long trip back to Rutherford. Well, I really hope you enjoyed that little glimpse into Karen and my life. Some of our friends that you might not get to meet unless you visited with us. And here in the year of the Chicky Plain, just when you think it's over, it's only beginning. And one of the things I have, I didn't get a chance to include this in on the videos before the Nats, I have some great footage from Rich Wallbridge. This is some really nice footage. Now, this is what I like about having the little group of friends we have. We can share this footage. We can share our passion for the models. And it gives you a little glimpse into other people's lives that you normally wouldn't have. Now this is the passenger seat while I'm busy in the shop here and I've been watching Rich Wallbridge's footage. I'm going to include it in on this video. But here's the point that I wanted to make. This is the rear passenger seat. I don't have a passenger seat. I have the pegs taken off the bike. And what I wanted to do is make, instead of a cushion, a little carbon fiber piece that would be a back support like I have on the other motorcycle. I've found that to be very comfortable for the way I like to ride and my back. I like to have a little bit of a back support. This really didn't have a back support for whatever reason. And I'm gonna make my own. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut and make this out of balsa wood. When I'm done with all the balsa carving, I'll make sure I have the shape that I want and I'll actually probably go take a ride and see if it's comfortable. And then I'll cover it with carbon fiber and try to put on
what I hope is going to be a really nice finish to match the other parts. Now I'm hoping this week or maybe next week I'll get the seat that the driver sits on from Elaine Brookins, and I'll already have this done and I can have those coordinated pieces. So this is the footage we got from Rich Wallbridge before the Nat. Sorry I didn't put it on before then, but Rich, thank you so much for sharing this footage.
Fresno from the Central Valley. Here, heading out towards the Northwest Regionals. And I should be reaching Sacramento about 250 miles or so. Start the trip off with some Black Sabbath. Just cruising along. It's about 5:15 on Thursday. Not much out here. Just a bunch of car dealerships. Nothing too exciting there. Yosemite sign. Just cruising along. I know people probably think I'm crazy here driving along with a video camera, but oh well. Oh, and hey, Wendy, this isn't as easy as you think it is. Or, this isn't as easy as I thought it was. There we go. That's what I want to say.
All right, here we are. Driving on Highway 99. It's like a little while until the sun comes up, but just traveling along here.
Highway 99 runs up to Sacramento. After Sacramento, we'll get on Interstate 5, which actually runs from probably Tijuana to Canada. So, driving along. It's mostly agriculture and farming and livestock and all that stuff in Fresno. But there are other things, such as architecture, if you can believe that. So there I am in the mirror. You can see the cardinal back there. Just driving along. Okay, here we are, passing through downtown Sacramento. It's like a guy almost runs me over. Okay. So, for those of you who don't know, Sacramento is the capital, and it's where the governor lives. So, here we are, driving through. It's about 7:30, so I'm missing the commute traffic, which is good. Okay, we're in extreme Northern California. Right in front of us is Mount Shasta. I don't know the elevations of it, but we're just driving along here. You can tell it's a holiday weekend. Look at all the campers and trailers and stuff. Everybody's out for the long haul today. We're about 396 miles into the trip. Took a hour and a half break and just ready to be on the road again for the duration of the trip up to Eugene, Oregon. All right, we just came down the Siskiyou's Mountain Pass. We're in Oregon already. Coming up on Ashland and Medford. Again, here's beautiful shots of Oregon. Oh, the weather is just beautiful, but obviously no clouds in the sky. Great afternoon drive. There's more pretty Oregon. Jamming along to the radio. Actually, CD. Going. Oh, we're cruising about 80.
Sam's Judges Camp, 2009 Pacific Northwest Regionals.
Okay, flyers! Flyers! Whoa! Contestants, we have a concourse trophy. So you need to get a little piece of paper, write down the name, the pilot, instead of their AMA number.
What if they don't know? What if they don't know? That's why you put the AMA in the
box. Well, then I have to go around and look at all that. Wait a minute here. All vote for this?
All right.
Who don't you know?
He's all right with me.
So,
for sufficient funds.
I know you're going to agree.
Which plan is this?
Which one?
Which one is Wendy's?
That's Hillary. That's my favorite.
Paul Walker's plan? Dan Rutherford's plan?
You want to turn him in or right here?
Bill Granderson's playing.
Don't forget there's advanced airplanes that might look pretty down here.
Yeah. There's Bob Duncan's airplane.
Greg, have you got one?
Yeah, what a ripoff.
I'm torn.
Is that Walker's Walker?
Which one this is? I'm torn.
Gordon's trying to hit?
Pretty obvious thing.
Not starting. Didn't he already get his time?
That's okay with starting right up.
Yeah. You started right up this morning, too. Come on, engine. Come on. Come on, pop. Now. That's it. Call it yet. We call it. Ah, oh, bummer. Did you want you over there?
Can I leave it
here? Yeah, leave it here. I'm not going to get the judge's perspective because they're over there.
But it means I'm over here.
Yeah.
can't see the intersection. Yeah, you can't hear. Can't see the intersection stuff in here.
If I can get all of it.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Uh-oh. Oh, his battery's down low too. Oh, Rich's battery as well. Take a picture of that video camera if you want. I'm gonna get run over with mine.
Battery's going down.
It's not automatic, it's just a pain.
Like, it's like almost dead. Look at that.
How do I get it up here, this display?
LA traffic. Mark up front. We got Fred driving. Typical LA traffic.
Yeah, that's
we got Walter Hicks in the back seat here.
Laughing at Fred's.
Looks like we got it loaded up already.
Fred is tailgating like a madman.
It's gonna go right now. Here we go.
Hi, Stan. Well, we know where all the cops are.
Oh, wow.
Whoa. Look at that wreck. Only in LA.
Whoa!
One, two, yeah, you know what? One hit and the other son of a bitch is we're looking.
Whoa, now we're moving. Hang on.
Mine is that bad, it's just a little twitchy. Yeah, look at the LA horizon.
There are mountains here, but you can't see them.
Yeah, too much smog in the air.
Twice as big as what we have in the valley, though. That's what's amazing, man.
Well, yeah,
what?
It is.
This is where the Raiders are supposed to play, huh?
No, not there. Across from the Miller Brewery in Irwindale. Right up here.
Out here.
my brother's old lady has a couple of those.
That's never heard, heard of it.
The bad thing about it, I introduced him to her. But I the first teachers are here, I got her a broom and I put a pair of handlebars on it and had a seat. Man, you got shrimps in there too.
Oh, yeah.
Now that's big.
Wow.
get a good picture of that.
Yeah, yes, I will.
For the wind.
Wow. Yeah, eat your heart out, Wendy. Eat your heart out. All right. Now it can officially start here. Where is the beer?
Right there in front of you, that red one.
All right.
There's some in the refrigerator.
Oh, this is just beautiful, Warren.
I like that.
Yum yum.
That is the 36-inch by
Woo! Good stuff.
Hey, it's Larry. Attaboy, Larry. Attaboy, attaboy, attaboy. Hey!
Okay, we're in Warren Walker's shop here. Warren asked me to pan around a bit. See, in a beautiful shop. Absolutely beautiful shop. Of course, there I have the Strega. Oh, air conditioning and everything. Boy, it's nice.
Let me get you one.
This is just a shop to die for. If I had this, I wouldn't even go back in the house. Hey, Anton.
Hey, Rich.
Mark, hey.
Whatever the hell you are.
Get my name right, man. drinking the vino, eh? What do we got here?
Merlot.
Okay.
We made it in good time, considering
how.
Let there be airplanes. There were airplanes, and they were good.
Yeah, that's a good old days.
You are. Ugly.
What kind of wine is that, Anton?
I mean, I know several people that have.
Do you know what year?
Meridian Silver Reserve Merlot 2005.
He's got an airplane.
Sounds like a good year.
Yeah,
he does.
Doesn't everybody?
If he has
a chance. No, I don't. That's the only reason my wife won't let me hang one in there. Damn.
Uh-oh. What are you doing there, Fred? You okay, Fred? And then we got this Larry guy over here.
Yo, OE, what's going on, OE?
See.
Did you ever see this?
Guess where this video is going, Larry?
Oh, God.
It's going to Joyzy, eh?
Joyzy!
Yo, Wendy!
Yeah. That's where this is going, eh?
That's my Mars over there! Right there, that's my Mars!
Yeah.
That's the checkmate over here!
Yeah, the 12-point check and the 14-point check.
Let's see what else we've got here. There's my Mars over there!
Yeah.
Hey, somebody's flying Miss Ashley.
Hey, that's me with my Pilot's Choice Concourse Award over here!
Bob
Palmer? Crusader, wasn't it? No, I won it for the checkmate.
Oh, did you?
Yeah. For you. And then the next year, I won it with the Crusader.
What do you
mean? It's like the museum over here.
Yeah, Warren's got a beautiful show. Well, Larry, I like your Stuka better.
I want to get a picture of Dennis's and mine put together. Yeah, the more I fly that, the more I'm starting to like it. I gotta ride one of these things? Rich?
Uh-huh. Damn. Warren Walker Striga. 2009. Nice joke. Down in Whittier Narrows. Pretty fancy there, Warren. Our friend Mark Wozniak. This is Trivial Pursuit. This is Crusader and my Cardinal. The far circle, the advanced and expert circle, and there's Warren. Okay, Warren Walker's first expert flight for this Striga. The 2009 Knights Joust at Whittier Narrows, May 30th and 31st. Yeah, looks like we have Larry Fernandez of the Buttafuoco stunt team launching for Warren. Warren's running a PA-75 and a rear exhaust muffler.
Warren. Hey, all right, Warren. Do the Strega owners proud.